So the first thing I did was build the foundation. I started with smooth sandstone as my base because I knew I wanted this barn to be built with smooth sandstone as the feature. So I basically decided how many stalls I wanted, how I wanted the layout to look, and as you can see, I dug out the floor so that I would be able to fill it in later with the flooring I wanted. And I wonder what the hell we were thinking of. Oh, I can't believe I kid myself again. Well, now I'm letting go. And all my fear, I've been fearing this too long. And as you can see here, I keep checking to see what I did on the other side because I totally messed the second side up at first. It was hard to get it symmetrical, but I eventually did figure it out. Next, I'm going in with some cobblestone flooring, like a mossy cobblestone flooring, and just placing that where I know I want the aisleways to be between the stalls. And I'm starting to build a stairway that will lead up into an upper floor, like an attic type room. It was just easier to build the stairs first. Next, I went in and started adding redstone where I wanted the individual stalls to be lit up. And I set up the redstone lighting to make sure it worked first. I went ahead and added in stable doors and windows. It took me so long to figure out what type of flooring I wanted to use for the stables, so you'll see it change like 100 times. And then I started building the second floor and the balcony. So here you can see I'm kind of adding a little balcony area with fencing. And I messed it up a little bit and changed my mind 100 times, but it all worked out fine. Now I'm just kind of building the basic concept for the stall that I wanted. And I'm just kind of doing the same thing throughout the rest of the building, trying to build up all the walls and shaping all the stalls. Okay, here I'm building up the stairs a little bit more and building some blocks across the roof just so I can make sure it's level and so I can decide where I want the redstone to go for the aisleways. Here I'm just punching out the walls for the doors and the windows for each stall and building up the walls to the same height across so that I can build the second floor roof. Okay, now that I decided the redstone was gonna work for that one stall, I just started adding in the redstone to all of the stalls individually. installing all of the doors and the windows for the stalls. These doors are meant so that the horses will be able to enter and exit the pasture as needed. Don't let the speed of sound leave you feeling paralyzed. Slow down, cause your words are saying something different. Here I'm just building the walkway for the stairs up into the loft, and I'm redoing the floor once again, and I think that's the last time I'll change it. And now I'm kind of just changing the look of all of the stalls to make them match, adding some little details. I'm using dark oak wood planks, I think. Not planks, but blocks. And I'm lining the bottom block of the whole building with the dark oak logs. That was just to give it a nice little touch and make the sandstone pop, not be so bland. Okay, now I'm going in and changing all of the stall flooring to the sand. I definitely should have done this when I did the aisleway floor, but I didn't know still what type of floor would look best with the interior, so this took kind of a while. Now I'm just filling in all of the walls between each stall so that they have a little window so the horses can see each other, and some acacia fencing between each one so they don't, you know, jump into each other's stalls. Right now, you got me feeling like I can't believe I let you go. And now I'm placing gates in each stall with some more acacia fencing and just some fencing on the sides to make it look nice. Then I realized that the redstone went one too far. When you were in the stall, it was like uneven, which really bothered me. So I went and changed the redstone on all of them. Next, I went in and added water and water buckets to each stall. As you can see earlier, I accidentally spilled water all over a stall, which is always my favorite. Next, I added a switch on the outside of each stall door, just so that you can open and close the gates and let the horses in and out. And I added a bunch of redstone so that the lighting turned on. I'm adding redstone also in the aisleways, making sure it's nice and even, and kind of organizing where I want redstone, how to make it symmetrical, things like that. Don't let the speed of sound leave you feeling paralyzed. Slow down, cause your words are saying something different than your eyes. And I'm still just filling in the walls. This is what's going to be the office. So I'm just trying to figure out how I want the redstone to go for the office and filling in all of the walls. After I filled in all the walls, I just went ahead and added redstone to every single redstone lamp so that it was nice and well lit. And now I'm just adding a second floor flooring, so one block above the redstone so that it still stays lit, but then you can't see it from the top floor, if that makes sense. Next, I'm kind of working on where I want the roof to go. So it took me a little while to figure out how I wanted it to be patterned. I'll go back and change it in a second. But I'm just building the roofing how I want it, and then building a symmetrical roof line on the opposite side of that balcony door and creating the first of many roofs. And then I went out on the inside and made sure the entryway from the stairs from the second floor made sense. Now I'm going in on the sides and building an additional roof line that will go towards the central roof line. And I'm just trying to make it so that it's tall enough, but not too tall that it like takes over the first roof line. And here I'm just building that first roof line, deciding where I want the windows to go. And all my fear, I've been fearing this too long. Now I was just looking at the roofline measurements to make sure I could build an identical one on the other side, which I'm starting to do now. And now that both rooflines are completed, I'm going in on the wings and building another roofline that connects into the second and third rooflines. Now I'm just going in on the other side and doing the same thing I did on the right wing. Think fast, don't let the speed of sound leave you feeling paralyzed. Next I'm going in and building a little overhang all around the entire perimeter of the barn. Just to make sure there's nice shade for the horses, and it also just looks pretty. Oh, show me how that you will leave me wanting more. And it took me a little while to figure out how I wanted the overhang, how far I wanted it to go, and on each side, where I wanted to place the pillars, things like that. So that's kind of just what I'm doing now. Next, I went in. At first I thought I was gonna build like individual grazing areas. So I went and built like an individual area for each horse because I didn't want them to get all mixed up in their stalls. Later, I decided that it looked ugly. So I just made it one communal area. They could all go out and graze and then come in and out of their various stalls, whatever. It just looked more aesthetically pleasing. And I went ahead and added, you know, some flowers, some grass, just to make it look pretty. And here's me destroying my individual stalls. That was fun and took a long time. Okay, here I'm building the loft, so I put in some chandeliers, a fireplace, I'm just kind of building it like a bed, putting a little couch area, just making it nice and cozy, and I'm changing up the roof line to make it more look more like walls instead of like a roof. Right now, and I added in a little kitchen area. Can't believe I let you go. I've been alone so long, and now then I just added in, you know, some nice finishing touches, some paintings, things like that. Okay, next I went in and built up the tack up areas, the storage areas, the stairs. I added hay bales to both corner stall areas. I built a tack room with places to hang bridles and saddles, as well as a feed room where you can prepare different kinds of feed for the different horses' diets. Next, I'm going in and deciding how I want the office. I realized I wanted windows first in the feed room and the tack room, so I'm putting windows in. And then I went ahead and built up the office. The desks, a little lobby area for visitors, maybe new riders, things like that. You know, some aesthetic things. And a rug, because what is an office without a rug? Also a library. And some plants. Okay, since that was super fast, I'm gonna go ahead and give you guys a little tour of the barn so you can see each individual area up close and in, you know, normal speed. So let's get started. Okay, here's us walking into the stable. So on the left is the light switch, in front of us is the office. We have a little tack area slash storage, and then we have stalls all along here. Right in the corner there is a hay bale, a bunch of hay bales. And here is the tack up room, places to hang saddles and bridles, and then a center area to put horseshoes and other things down. There's more stalls along the back. There's the staircase and more areas to keep tack and storage. And then here's the office with the library. More chests to store stuff, the lobby area I talked about, a great view outside. There's the desk. And we have more stalls as we go along the other side. So with the tack room on the left, on the right here, we have the feed room. So we have different choices of feed and a little sink area. And more hay bales in this corner. This stable is great because it has room for plenty of stalls and it's nice and spacious as well. Okay, now we're taking the stairs up into the loft. So there's the bed area. It has a little platform to get up there. A nice view in the window. There's a couch with a fireplace, lots of cool paintings. A dining table, and our little kitchen area, cutting board, stove, and fridge, everything you need. Out here is the balcony, which leads us back to the front of our stable, which is where we started. So yeah, that's pretty much it for the barn. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this little speed build and tour. Let me know if you'd like to see more of these videos. If so, what types of barns you want me to build next, or stables. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!